Well, when you think of pizza, you think of Italy, right? No, not anymore. The world champion pizza maker comes from right here in Australia. Melbourne's Johnny DeFrancesco joins us now with the secret to the perfect pizza. Welcome back.
How are you?
Now, you've just beaten 600 chefs from all over the world for this title.
Yep.
Ooh.
That's amazing. Wow. How did that go down with the locals? They must have been
furious. Oh, they were happy.
What's the secret to the world's best pizza?
Good dough, great ingredients, and a lot of love.
Ah. Yeah.
So you're going to show us what we need to do?
Yes. So I want to demonstrate today how we make, if I can reach over, some dough. So that everyone at home can actually make this dough really simply, really easy. Ah. And people,
first time anyone's made any dough at this network.
Yeah. So people actually think that it's difficult to make pizza at home, right?
Yeah.
It's actually not. So I want to teach everyone how we're going to make a pizza dough that you can actually make the day before.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next day, without stress, just make a pizza.
All right.
Right? So really simple ingredients. This is a recipe that I use every day in my own restaurant. So obviously, smaller, 600 mils of water, kilo of flour.
Just normal, like not hot water, it's just cool?
Cool water.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. 1 to 3 grams of fresh yeast, like really tiny amount of yeast.
Is that what it looks like? I thought that was a cherry pit.
No. And some salt, so 30 grams of salt. Mm-hmm. So we add that into the water first because it's really important that we dissolve the salt.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then where a lot of people make a lot of mistakes is they actually put the yeast in now. And what happens is they kill the yeast. We don't want to kill the yeast. We want that to stay alive. So what we do is we add a little bit of flour, about 20% of what we're going to use.
Self-raising?
No. No. What? Double zero flour. So you want to use some very fine milled flour. So I use Italian flour.
Mm-hmm.
So we then...
Can you use normal flour, though?
You can use normal flour. Mm-hmm. You can use normal flour.
So just plain white flour.
Yeah, no plain problem. White flour, no self-raising.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so we get a bit of a liquidy mix.
Wow,
we then just grab the yeast, drop it straight in.
Yep.
So we don't need to dissolve the yeast in any water, because that's what a lot of people do, you know, and they're wasting time. So we don't want to do that. So
and then you mix up the yeast in your finger?
Break it up and that will be dissolved as it is. And then what we do is we continually add a little bit of flour until we get to the point where we can, I love the music.
Johnny, when you finally made your dough, when you've got a good consistency going on with the dough, it's all in the toss, isn't it?
It is all in the toss. Well, I think you should have a go at tossing.
Joe, I guess you could be called the show's prize.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I'm a great
That joke was written for me.
No, it was absolutely true. Everyone says I'm a massive tosser.
No, you're not. You're lovely, Joe.
What's show?
You ready?
Is it in the wrist?
Okay. Hey, that was not
me.
Okay. So what do I do here?
So I think you should try and throw it up in the air. No. Hopefully it doesn't land anyone. So that's it.
Oh, good job. Not bad.
It's amazing how it stays together. So.
What's the point of throwing it in the air like that? Is that really helping it?
No,
it doesn't help.
You'll have a go.
Sorry. Okay, you have a toss.
Oh, that wasn't bad.
It's fantastic. You could also use it as sort of as a tea towel. You know, face washer.
Yeah, we normally we get
a scarf.
Yep, tissue.
A scarf.
Yeah.
Okay.
We actually make larger ones. We make wedding dresses at the moment, so anyone interested?
Okay.
All right, so what's next?
So we obviously mix, and we don't have all the time to mix. We probably mix about 10 minutes.
Yep.
And our dough will then come into
a
combined ball.
And then it goes in here.
And then we
chuck it in
obviously
there.
Cook.
So if you have one of these things...
Yep, you can cook in your own oven at home. So, again, you can get a pizza stone, put it into the oven.
Or a sandwich maker. Could you put it in the sandwich maker?
No, I don't think it'll fit.
Wow. Yeah, but a bigger one?
If I just put my one in here and just see if that...
You can.
Works,
That's the way.
It always goes awry when we cook on this show.
There we go.
Perfect.
Nice.
And then
a little bit of
beauty. Can we put that down?
Yeah.
Is that it?
Okay.
All right, so we need to go to the final one because we're running out of time.
Yeah, let's go. So we're going to make...
Oh, this is the magic of television.
Yep. So, see how good
yummy.
It is?
Yummy.
Oh.
And I'm loving the look of you got like a tomato in...
Yes.
paste or
so
sauce?
Beautiful Sammazzano tomato, really high quality.
And you could use just canned tomatoes, couldn't you?
You can, yes.
Canned tomatoes, got a bit of basil there.
Yeah.
And the buffalo mozzarella.
So we're going to put some buffalo mozzarella on this.
That's where buffalo wings come from.
Yes, they do.
But isn't that good just breaking up with your fingers? Yeah. I always think I've got to cut it, chop it.
And we put the lid on. Now, with an oven like this, I would put the basil on later.
Okay.
But if you've got a wood fire oven at home and you're lucky to have one, then put the basil on top before.
Okay, yeah. I know when I'm cooking with my wood-fired oven at home, I always put the basil in first.
Yeah, I've had people to do that for you, Joe.
tell my assistant to put the basil in first.
You can taste Johnny's award-winning pizza at one of his three Melbourne 400 Grady restaurants, and he's just about to open his fourth. He's doing that well. Johnny, congratulations on the honour. Best pizza in the world.